Hi, we're going to stripe this nice 1931 very unusual pickup truck. We're going to use this incredible bright cherry red. Ronin makes a great red. And we're going to mix up an oak color. And a charcoal. And that's our palette. I want them to be in.
Hi, I'm Lauren Holbrun. Ford Motor Company was in its heyday in the 20s. It had just completed the run of about 16 million Model Ts in 1927, and in 1928 it introduced the Model A. And this is a Model A. It ran from 1928 to 1931. It was a smashing success in its early years, and of course the Depression hit in 1930 and 31, and so the quantities were dramatically reduced. I'm a real hot rod fanatic, and I have always wanted a Model A. And this one came to my attention, and I just loved everything about it. I love the look of the Model A. I love the rareness of this stake bed utility and service truck. This is powered by a GM Fastburn ZZ4 425 horsepower hot cam GM crate motor. It has all the goodies in it. If you want to take a look here, we can open this side.
Al, is it okay if Lauren opens the hood while you're striping?
Sure, it'd be like a real job.
Yeah, right. Let's have a look here. So this is really a hot motor. And this truck, for a truck, really goes. This engine is tied to a 700 R4 transmission and a 9-inch Ford rear end. So it's one hot rod truck. So I hope you enjoy seeing it as much as I enjoy owning it. Thanks very much.
To motor west, travel my way, take the highway, that's the best. Get your kicks on Route 66. It winds from Chicago to LA, more than 2,000 miles all the way. I get your kicks on Route 66. Now you go through St. Louis, Joplin, Missouri, and Oklahoma City looks mighty pretty. You'll see Amarillo, Gallup, New Mexico, Flagstaff, Arizona, don't forget Winona, Kingman, Boston, San Bernardino. Aren't you get hip to this timely tip when you make that California. I get your kicks on Route 66.
Tommy the Greek was credited to the teardrop, I recall. It's like an inverted teardrop, water drop.
And why these colors?
It's the interior color. Stripes should be on the outside edge, but this looks better here. When you have a hot rod, there is no correct way. It's your way. Originally, there was one stripe on this belt molding where I'm working that was about as thick as the tape, about an 1/8-inch stripe. That was it. One stripe, nothing else. It's so narrow in here.
Correct.
Originally, the seat would be about here where my hand is. You'd have to be a really small guy to get in there. That's why the seat's so far back, so you can fit. Hot rods were more, they were built in the 40s and 50s, so the parts were all old and just what you could find. And street rods have all the most modern drivetrain and everything. You get the brush and you go do stuff.
Wait, so the original gas was in the top, and now it's in the back?
Yeah, originally you have the gas tank right over your lap, nice and safe. What are you, like, folding or something?
Alan, where are you? What are you doing?
I'm under the car because I was bad. Lauren, would you like me to check the oil or the rear end here?
Sure, I'm here. And your wrench there.
Oh, boy. You sure you want to be a pinstriper? You too can make money and travel the world as a pinstriper and get in strange situations.
Sorry.
No longer go under cars. We only go on the cars, not
this
under.
This is the last inaugural undercar move.
The last time in history that this will be done. Although this is actually an easy one. Gotta be a better way, though.
Look at this cool O. They should have kept it like that. That's pretty neat.
Ford. Okay.
Very nice.
I get your kicks on Route 66. I get your kicks on Route 66. I get your kicks on Route 66. I get your huss. I get your huss. Get your kicks on Route 66.